dengan iron. Earlier I did mention bahawa reaction dengan iron very important. Now I'm going to ask one question, see who can give me the answer. Okay, now this is for chlorine. Remember, concentrated hydrochloric acid and potassium manganate 7, when they react, they can bebaskan chlorine gas. Gas chlorine lalu melalui delivery tube ini masuk ke dalam tabung pembakaran yang memang sudah ada kapas besi yang panas. Alright, kapas besi yang panas. Alright, so kemudian soda lime. Soda lime untuk menyerap gas chlorine yang berlebihan. Excess gas chlorine. Now my question. Why they use, of course they are reacting with ferrum. Ferrum ialah besi, iron. But why we use iron wool, kapas besi? Mengapa kapas besi digunakan? What's the reason? Can I gunakan besi or not? Why must be kapas besi? Kenapa tak gunakan ketulan besi? Why must use kapas besi or iron wool? Any reason? Who can give me the best answer? React easily, too general. Be more specific. React easily, not wrong, but not specific yet. Any other reasons we think? Mengapa kapas besi digunakan bukannya ketulan besi? Why they use iron wool? Alright, in chemistry there are three types of wool kita boleh gunakan. Like easily burn, easily burn, easily burn. Still not. No, you haven't answered in terms of chemistry yet. Easily burn. Easily burn. Anyone, try a little bit more. You're somewhere there. Because you're easily burn, react easily will be the second part of the answer. The main reason, belum kita berikan lagi. The main reason why it works, why we use iron wool. Where's Hongkiat? Hongkiat can answer or not this question? Alright, this is because if you know, okay, allow the air to pass through easily, allow the air, no. Reason kita gunakan iron wool atau kapas besi ialah, they have a larger total surface area. When you have a larger total surface area, that's chemistry. Larger total surface area exposed, then only we can follow Sweeting's answer, whereby it reacts much more faster. So kalau if I use like a iron, larger piece of iron, what will happen is that the total surface area exposed is smaller. Lebih kecil jumlah luas permukaan terdedah, maka kadar tidak balasnya lebih rendah. Alright, so this I still can excuse you because you haven't learned this part of the chemistry yet. So when anything that is like example, why they use powder? Why not a grain? Powder, larger total surface area. So therefore, they react faster. Easily can take part in chemical reaction. Huh? Okay, good. Anyway, those who tried, very good. So this for gas. So kalau liquid, macam mana pula? Okay, for bromine. Bromine. So this is a, sorry, this is a second. No, I don't have a bromine one here, I think. This is iodine. Kalau bromine, let them vaporize and then we heat up. Now, dalam gambar aja ini juga. So tengok ni. Bagi iodine ini, ada heat juga. Which one you kena panaskan dulu? Always panaskan iron wool dahulu. Why? So that they become reddish, burning, membara. Then only allow the gas pass through, reaction will take place. Soda lime, they ask you, what's the purpose of using soda lime? Because these gases are chlorine, bromine, iodine, like a toxic gases. You cannot inhale much. So you cannot just release the gas, excess gas into the atmosphere, just like that, in the lab somehow. So jadi kita gunakan soda lime to absorb all these excess gases saja. Now how about the chemical reaction? Alright, this observation, the reaction we'll see. Chlorine, bromine, iodine all react in the same manner. Apa dia? Burns brightly. The difference is the reaction, reactivity saja. The way they react is still the same. Chlorine burns brightly. Bromine glows brightly. Iodine glows dimly sebenarnya. Lebih malap sedikit. So reactive mesti kena berkurangan. But the product forms brown color solid. Some more brown color solid. So whether chlorine, bromine, or iodine, they will form brown color solid. Why brown? Because of this. The FeX3, maybe FeCl3 or Br3 or I3, semuanya berwarna perang, brown, because of the ferrum, rust color. So this is a general equation. So let's try the equation. This will be an equation. Everything given. The name of the product. FeCl3, apa cara nama? How to call this the name of it? So we call it, anyone want to try first? Just FeCl3, what's the name of FeCl3? FeCl3, apa nama dia? FeCl3. FeCl3, FeBr3, not that famous. FeCl3 is very famous. Apa nama dia FeCl3 ni? Anyone? I count 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so jawapannya ialah iron 3 chloride. Nombor 3, Roman, number 3 is needed. That's iron 3 lah, Fe3 plus. So ferrum 3 chlorida, ferrum 3 bromida, ferrum 3 iodida. It works like that. Alright, so ini chemical equation dia. Nama penuh mereka, everything is there. Okay, next kita lihat tentang reaction with sodium hydroxide. Okay, so chlorine, halogen, chlorine contoh dengan nitrogen hydroxide. Macam mana tidak balas mereka? So once again, arsenic and gas chlorine, these are the product. Just now kita lalukan ke dalam air suling, distilled water. Now into the sodium hydroxide. So then only they will react. That will react. Kalau dia bromine, drop it into sodium hydroxide solution. Kalau dia, let's say, iodine solid, place it inside, then you pour sodium hydroxide ke dalamnya. So, 3 gambar aja ada dalam nota anda juga. So, the product, almost the same. Only the reactivity saja berbeza. Chlorine dissolve quickly, bromine slowly, iodine a bit slow, little lah. But the product, chlorine, yellow-greenish color solution, changes to colorless. Reddish brown color changes to colorless. So reddish brown because of bromine, then it changes to colorless. Iodine, black crystal changes to colorless. Semua jadi colorless iron. Alright? Chemical equation. Why they become colorless, you see? Now this is a halogen, X2. React dengan sodium hydroxide. Why reversible arrow? Reversible arrow means forward pun boleh berlaku, reverse pun boleh berlaku. Normally, you learn this in acid base. Kalau ada reversible equation, both direction, the reaction can proceed. Alright, so dua-dua arah depending on the concentration normally. Now, kita dapat NaX plus NaOX. Campur air. Okay, follow the general equation. Write for chlorine, bromine, and iodine. All three of them. Okay, try. All three of them. Tuliskan persamaan-persamaan mereka. I give you siapa sudah, let me know. Got two chats here. Iron sweet things, answer just now correct. Iron chloride cementa can. But then, since iron ada two oxidation number, we must be specific. Iron 3. Iron chloride means can be iron 2 as well. So, only the 3 is missing. Okay, so sweet thing has done it. Let's check the answer. This is the answer. All the equation. Just gantikan X dengan chlorine, bromine, iodine saja. Now I'm interested to know the name of NaOCl. Who can give me the name of NaOCl? What is the name of the compound? NaOCl. Just now we had a what we call HOCl. Now we are having a NaOCl. Tadi ya. Hypochlorous acid. Ini macam mana pula? Kalau NaOCl, apa nama dia? Apakah nama yang diberi? Sodium chlorate. Yes, correct. Sodium chlorate 1 is even better. That's chlorate 1 lah. So, jadi nama dia, sodium chlorate is not wrong. Sodium chlorate 1. Sebab sini ada oxidation number. The 1 mewakili nombor pengoksidan bagi chlorine di sini. sodium chloride 1, sodium bromide 1, sodium iodate 1 as well. Let's go!